ist. So. Mit. Okay, guys. So, here's the game. As far as the eye, is it cold? It got released today. So, here the graphic settings, which you can change a little bit. Then we have audio here. So, make it not like this. So audio settings. We have some interface settings. There are different languages in case you're interested. There's Francais, something, something, something. Spanish, Polish, and German. So in case you're interested. Here is some gameplay stuff you can set. And there also are key bindings here also. I did not change anything, so everything what I have is default. Sure. And then we have to test. So I would say we go for the campaign or and see how it goes and play the story. So select a chapter. Chapter 1, Orko the Vigilant. Orko the Vigilant. In this first chapter, guide Orko the Eye by repairing a bridge. Learn how to move units and explore. Gather resources, complete your objectives, and prepare the caravan for the departure. Lulu and Orko await you for the first adventure accessible to all. Okay. So. At the cusp of the 456th blink, the sigh awakens. The growling of the waves freed from its long slumber. Its time has come. So, it speeds. The water approaches and the cycle begins again. The wave comes to cover the earth and ensure its prosperity for future generations. In the meantime, guided by the wind, the peoples of this island must take shelter. Pupils set off on their long journey to meet up the eye. The cyclical sanctuary, place of the great meeting. They will live together until the next separation, at the end of the cycle. Here, they will share the knowledge gained during the last 456 blinks. Later, the great tears will drain away, and it will be time to leave and start all over. So, you are the wind. You awaken to the sound of lapping water. The cycle begins again. It is time to accomplish your destiny. This is Orko. Orko is a pupil. Pupils are little curious beings that live in harmony with nature. They form tribes and settle in little villages. To move the camera around Orko, use the mouse wheel button. The mouse wheel lets you zoom in and out. Okay. Okay, zoom out, zoom in. And we can also rotate. This bar represents the time. So here, this bar here. Represents the time it will take for events and the waters to arrive in the stage. The wave is here. Yeah. It comes closer to Orko each turn. Okay. Orko is here. Yeah. In 30 turns, this land will be covered in water. You, the Sai, must save Orko. Okay. Open the map to find Orko's position in the world. Okay, we are here. Today, Orko is here. Orko lives very close to the eye and never has to go particularly far. So, until the last blink, until the wave appears on the horizon, Orko inspects the area around the eye. Orko's mission is to repair every damaged path to help other pupils on the last stretch of their journey. Each cycle, Orko welcomes the new tribes. Orko is always there when no one has yet arrived and always leaves when everyone else is already gone. And while waiting for their arrival, rubble must be cleared, rope bridges must be fixed, and trails must be placed. The eye is here. Yeah. Yes, the eye. At the end of the cycle, it is the destination for all pupil tribes. For Orko is the next step. Select a path or hold to find out the travel cost. Ah, here. So we need 10 food, 40, I don't know what, and 80 wood. Between Oko Stage and the Eye, there is a collapsed bridge that stops progress. It needs to rebuild using wood and ore. Collect these resources to help Oko make it to the Eye. Close the map to go back to the current stage. Okay. To repair the bridge, Oko went to collect some ore and already has 40 40 ore stored in transport balloons. Now, also here, genau, here, you see it? Ore. Now Oko needs to get the ore back to the tribe. Select Oko. Once Oko has been selected, you can whisper him to move. Right click on his hex and select the movement action so that Oko will go there. See? Holding down the right mouse button also lets you move the camera. What? Holding down the right mouse button. It did not work. Okay. Go to. In as far as the eye, actions take place at the end of the turn. To get Oko to move, click the next to the moon button. Here. Each turn that goes by, the wave will get closer to your stage. See? The wave is now moved here. Regera Okota, yes, Kurs. I think it's a turn-based city builder strategy game. Something like that, Zemi, but not the RTS. There's no fighting, as far as I know. Hallo Petit, how are you doing? Hello. So, but yeah, we have these balloons, which we have to use to transport stuff. So here you can see there's more ore. So, pupils spend movement points, MP, to move. These planes require 1 MP. Oko is 3 MP and can easily cross them. Okay. Get Oko to move to these planes using a right mouse click and the end of the turn related action. The exploration zone is represented by gray hexagons. Each pupil has a view range of 1 and will automatically uncover the hexagons located directly to the position. Okay. Okay, now we have to say here. The sound effects are really cute. As all lower arms, we are doing the wave. And the wave is bad. The wave will kill us, Vagabondo. And if the movement cost is higher than the number of MP available, the pupil will need several turns to finish their movement. Some types of terrain are harder to cross than others. Mountains require 4 MP. To cross a mountain hex, it will take Oko 2 turns. Move Oko there. Yeah. This is Lulu. Oh, here, das ist Lulu? Here, guys. Yes, look here. This is Lulu. I think. This is Lulu, the caravan. Help Oko to get there to drop off the 40 ore. Over long distances, a pupil will always choose the shortest pathway. So, let's go to Lulu. Oko has brought 40 ore to the caravan. The 40 ore are now in the stockpile. Resources can't be used until they have been put into the stockpile. Now only wood is needed to build the bridge. Wood can be found in forests and jungles. Explore the hall to find some. Okay, we need to find some wood. Achso. We don't see wood yet. Okay, guys, we have to find some wood. Also, ja. 1, 2, 3. Schade. Hier ist Water. Can't I? Ach so. Also nee, I have to... Nee. So do I have to... Achso, nee. Was? Why can't I move? Don't understand it. I click on him? So I can't go further? The map stops here maybe? Maybe it's dead. So I think I can't go here because the map is not there. Available? Maybe? I don't know. Okay, probably because I can't click here at all. Okay, I think like that. Only the gray, yeah. Got it now also. I thought I can go here because you see here also hexagons, so I thought we can also go there. Would be better if they would just make it like this so you don't see anything. So. Oh, there's wood. We need to assign Oko to a building for resources to drop off. Oko only is Lulu, the caravan to drop off any harvested resources. Select Oko, then right-click on the caravan and choose wood. End the turn to validate the action until Oko is transformed. You can also assign Oko to harvest by right-click directly on the forest. Oko will then choose the closest available building. But he said I should make this. Right click on the caravan. And choose wood. Right. Ah, here, okay. Or we make like this and then wood. What? Why is he going back now? But I don't have any wood. What? So did he have to go back to change his clothing for that? So. Among pupils, the red panda. What? What? It's a red panda? Really? Oh, see, guys. It's a red panda. Among pupils, the red panda form corresponds to the gatherer trait. Oko will be able to evolve in this form and gain experience in this trait. Oko took this shape in order to collect wood. When a trait is assigned, a pupil goes about their job independently. Oko will go collect wood in the forest and drop it off at the caravan without further instructions. There we go. So, okay, end the turn. Oko is not very experienced gatherer. It will take 3 turns to collect wood. Let Oko work. So, now we have our balloon with the wood. Oko has collected 40 wood. Yeah! Oko knows what to do and will bring the resources back to the stockpile without necessary instructions. As long as you don't give a pupil any other tasks, they will go and collect more resources by default. Complete the objective by bringing 80 wood to the stockpile. Note, interrupting a pupil carrying resources will make the pupil drop them and lose them. Before giving a new order to a pupil, make sure they are not carrying anything valuable. The rising water is announced by various vegeries. Vegeries. What does it mean? Vegeries? Events? I don't know. Vega Vagaris. The closer the waves, the more frequent the catastrophes. The wave is always preceded by enormous cataclysm and it's best to not tarry. A minor something will take place next turn. Okay. Lightning. Ooh. See? The clouds gather very quickly and suddenly. The storm is brief but violent, leaving chaos behind. 3 bolts of lightning strike at random, inflicting 100 damage to structures and igniting forests and jungles. He said, always here take care about what's happening. The clouds gather quickly and suddenly. The storm is brief but violent, leaving chaos behind. The 3 bolts of lightning strike at random. Yeah, okay. A bolt of lightning struck this forest. And the wood is burning. If Oko stays here, they might get badly burned. Oh. Oko still needs wood. Fortunately, the nearby jungle wasn't hit by the lightning. Assign Oko to harvest in the jungle by selecting Oko. Right click on the jungle and selecting wood. I wanted, but it did not go. And now it goes. Okay. Oh. Launen, Unwägbarkeiten, Tücken, Einfälle, okay. Was? Yeah, goo, wees? Unpredictable. Okay, now we have wood. If you bring it back. Hooray! All the necessary resources have been collected. Oko can immediately repair the bridge and move onwards to the eye. Open the map and tell Oko to leave by clicking on the destination. So, what? Oko can take some of the stockpile to the eye by organizing it on Lulu's back. The resources taken along for the journey follow the tribe to the next stage. In this case, they will be useful for the pupils to build the paradise in the eye. Select a resource and put it on Lulu's back. The resources you need to travel in this case to fix the bridge are removed from the stockpile before departure and are not available for organization. Well done. You helped Oko to the eye with a load of resources. Oko is safe. You must now guide other tribes here before the waves take them. Okay. As re like de, gu like gan. Achso, gu. Gan. Gu. Gan. Da. Wies like wies. Ah, difficult. Okay, good. So this was like a tutorial. I guess now it will get more difficult. Chapter 2, Linked by Destiny. Anki and Shoot must take one of the paths that lead to the next stage. Can you help them to get the necessary resources? Learn to choose a path according to the available resources and halt biomes. Construct buildings, tame rhinophalos, and trade on the market. Manage harvest cycles and discover pupils' different forms. Hanky and Shoot are ready to get the cracking. So I guess these are all probably, you know, parts of the tutorial, so we learn how everything is working. At dawn of the fifth blink, the great meeting is closed with the cycle ceremony. Every pupil must go to the summit of the great cliffs of the west. It is a hard task, but few do not undertake it. Those who do not join the side to guide their companions in future travels. At the summit, a vast plateau awaits the pupils, who sit in the concentric circles around the sacred stones. Here the tribes are reorganized. During the ceremony, each pupil is linked to two others, a new cycle. A cairn is assigned, and the next day they leave the eye for a new cycle. Two times already the ceremony has linked Shoot and Hank in the same cycle, a circle. Destiny has decided so. The cycle has reached its end and the wind and their balloons has come to announce the arrival of the waters. It is time to leave and make their way to the eye. This time, Shoot and Hanky will make the climb to the sacred plateau together. Even so, their egos will never let them speak of it. Their impatience for the ceremony is tempted by apprehension. This is the caravan. The tribe is composed of two pupils, Shoot and Hanky. Open a map to look at the tribe's journey. Okay, so we are here. Yeah. And we have to go here. Shoot and Hanky's tribe is currently two halls away from the eye. From their position, two different paths are available. each pass has its own difficulties and can lead to very different terrain in which it can be harder to progress. Select the top pass to see how much it costs. So we need here 10, 40, 80. And here we need 540 for food and 100 something. Okay, the top part is better, I would say. You can also directly select the next hall to find out the travel cost. Hallo Marmux. Maybe, I don't know, Quickstar. I guess we will find out what they are. So I guess we take the top one. Yeah. On the bottom pass, the tribe will have to cross a glacier to reach next hold. They will need to collect pepkins to have enough food and some stone. Note, this hold is a rainforest. There will be a lot of jungles and bogs, a lot of wood. But mosquito diseases, disease events are fatal. The tribe doesn't have the necessary resources to make this trip. You will need to find them at the current hold, harvest them and stock them. To know which path you can take, close the map by clicking on the current hold and explore the hold to find out what resources it has to offer. What? I need ore and food. Okay. Okay, so we should check what we can find, right? And then we can decide. Huh? Shirt and hanky are no part of the hold. Explore the hold to know your options. Each resource can be found only on specific hexes. You will never find pepkins on mountains or in lakes. Huh? Okay, we have here now. So here we have pepkins. Here we have stones. Huh? Ach so. Okay, so with pepkins and some stone, you can go via the glacier. If it's not already your current objective, select the glacier on the map screen, then close the map. Okay. Oh, yeah, this one, right? Did it say this one? I think so, all because we have pepkins and stone. I think this one. Pepkins are the base resources and can be harvested via the caravan. Assign Shut to collect pepkins by selecting each pupil, then right click on the hex corner on as a boss. End of turn. Pupils need space and two can't work on the same hexagon. Assign them each to their own hex or to the caravan so they can find their own hex and end the turn. I hope I made it now right. Okay. Huh? Okay, so now boss go here and then they should boss make that. Hanky and Shut have changed appearance to take on the gatherer form. They will each go to work on their own hex without getting in each other's way. The pupils will collect pepkins for 3 turns, drop them off on the stockpile, then go back to harvesting. The pupil will continue performing the same assigned action until you stop them or they run out of resources. Ah, you see? So now one went here and the other one here. Sounds like talking to ASMR. Yeah, they whisper. I mean, they said they are whispering, right? So they're all the time like, psh, 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 psh. I see here, you can see our pupils here. There. The bottom. So now they have gathered the stuff. Now we return it. These pepkins are much further than the stockpile building than the others. The pupil only has 3 MP per turn and will take much longer to go and form between the hex and to stockpile. It will take them many more turns to bring back the same amount of resources as the other pupil. Using this hex is not particularly efficient for now. One pupil will be sufficient. Hunky can handle it. Meanwhile, Shot will go and get some stone. Okay. Also, I can't make it like this. I can't make it like this and tell this guy to go here. I wanted that this one. Verstehe ich nicht. Why can't I tell this guy to go there? And he said the other one to do it, but I mean, this guy is gathering, so why should I remove him now from his work? Then I can take this guy and tell him go here, but when I click here, I can't. No building available to gather this resource. But it is here. Pupils can't collect ore or stone in the caravan. You need to construct a building, a quarry. Ah, select Shut and open the building menu. Where do I have to make that? Ah, so the other one doesn't have it. Okay, wait. Okay, so you go here. Okay, wait. So I take 2. I don't know why the other one can't do it. Maybe it's just because of the tutorial, I don't know. Building a permanent quarry requires 100 wood. Fortunately, Shut and Hunky already have that much in the stockpile. Ah, luckily. Okay, query. Buildings can only be built on planes. Be aware that any resources on the hex will be lost during construction. Place the query as close to the stone as possible to Shut, so Shut can gather quickly. Once the position has been indicated, Shut will go and build the designated structure. You can cancel the construction by clicking the destroy button. The used resources will be recuperated. Once the building has been fully built, if you destroy it, you get nothing back. Okay. And then you go here. Hello, Dominic. How are you doing? Oh, now I understood it, I think. So now this one. Hunky is there collecting and Shoot. Change now the form. Oh, see. Oh, now it's a bird. See? So building is a bird. This one now. So gathering is panda. You see? So that's the reason why we loot always so much. That's just in our nature. Well done. Shoot has built a quarry. You must now assign Shoot to stone collection. With a building or hills where the stone can be found. Huh? He did? Oh. See, now it's... I don't know what it is. So stone gatherer is a purple... I don't know what. Purple cute thing. Martin is excused for looting always. Oh, yeah. So. It looks a bit like an axolotl, I would say, just in purple. Okay. No. I just have to click, I guess. Axolotl, I saw the same, yeah. Oh, I think axolotl is probably... And pack animal, pepkin. Oh. Yeah. So I think you just have to click now that the turns go by. A hilt sells stone resources is depleted. But I need more stone. No? What should I do now when I don't have enough stone? Game. I need more stone. We need 20 more stone. Ah, now we have it. Okay. All the necessary resources have been obtained. Open the map and select the next hall to prepare to leave. Okay. The pepkin and stone needed for this journey have been removed from the stockpile, but some resources remain. Everything you leave behind will be lost. Take as many resources as you can by placing them on the caravan's back, and you will have them for the next hold. Then click leave. The permanent quarry will stay in this hold. Permanent buildings are cheap to build, but can't be moved or carried between holds. Build mobile buildings if you want to carry them. Oh, so you can also take buildings with you. Okay. So? Okay. The tribe has crossed the glacier and is now in a tropical hold. They must stop for a while so they can find the necessary resources to cross the next obstacle. However, the hold they left behind is now under the waves. They mustn't tarry on their way to the eye. The eye is the next hold. Select the eye or the path to the eye to find out what the pupils you need to gather there, then close the map. So we need to get 50 wood, 10 ore and 120 stone. Otso Matli, I don't know how it's called in English. In German we say Axolotl. Blumog wrote the word. So I'm not sure how it's called in English. This animals. Okay. This hold is a little different from the previous one. It's a tropical biome, where one will find more jungles and bogs than in other holds. In a regular playthrough, the pupils start their journey in a large, balanced hold, as it's where the tribe has decided to live for the cycle. As such, one can find practically everything there. Here's the caravan. This one here, which has just arrived at the hold. For now, the pupils are inside. They will get out when the beast has settled for installation. The caravan moves exactly like pupils, but only is 2 MP. Move the caravan to a, strategic location to install the camp. The caravan can't be set up upon a land that's too steep or too wet. It will only be happy on a plain, but can crush the trees of a forest to make enough space. Okay. Yeah, I would say probably it's better if our caravan is more in the middle. So if our guys have to walk left and right, they have a shorter distance to go. Or click on the installation button to install the caravan. Be aware, once installed, the caravan will not be moved again until the departure of the hold. Good night, Mina. Sleep well, sweet dreams. Thank you so much for joining. It was good to see you. I'm glad you got some rest. Let me just stay here now. So, okay, guys. That's really cute. It's like little houses and stuff here on the guy, right? That's really cute. Here are Shad and Hunky once again. They left their caravans back. Explore the map, gather the necessary resources to repair the railroad, then guide the tribe to the eye before the water rises. Okay, what's you? So here's a big guy. I don't know what he is. Okay. The entire map has been explored and not a trace of ore. No, you can't repair the railway line without ore. Whisper to Shad that they should build a market to be by opening Shad's construction menu in the selection window. A market is a building that allows resource trading with other tribes. Pupils attach crates of resources to the balloons, which, carried by the wind, quickly find a destination. Soon enough, the requested resource will find a way back, attached to a small balloon. Hey Alex, how are you doing? Hello! I hope you're feeling better. So? The market is an appendix. It's a structure built on the back of a pack animal. As such, each appendix requires you to have a rhinophalo in stock. Rhinophalos are base resources which can be gathered directly from the caravan. Find and collect rhinophalo in order to build a market. If you interrupt the pupil taking back resources to a building, these are lost. Unlike other resources, there's only one rhinophalo per hex. Wait for the pupil to bring it to the caravan. Okay. Pack animal. Okay. So, what do we have together? Stone. For that we need a quarry. What else do we need? Nothing. Whatever. As now, oh, it's this, they changed now. You see, they're now like little bears, little bear, and then now they're a grower. I've been the same for a long time. I expect I will go back to work in a week or so. How are you? I'm really good. Did you go now back? Did you get to back your taste and everything? Oh, look! Oh, love! That's really cute, though. So many hearts. I guess they were taming them, that they go with us to our station here. They're on the balloon now, you see? Oh, that's really adorable. All the necessary resources to build a market have been obtained. Choose a pupil to build it, then select market in the appendix tab of the construction menu. Okay, now boss can it, okay. An appendix can only be built on a hex adjacent to the caravan, and only on a plain or a forest. This is why the placing of a caravan is important. It needs to be near base resources like wood or pepkin, but also be adjacent to plains or forests so you can build up. Okay. Got it. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I have a market and now. Achso. And we need a quarry. Oh, for quarry we need a wood. Okay, so we make him a wood gatherer. So now she's... she's building now. She's building out a market, you see? See the stones and everything flying around? My smell comes and goes. When it's back, maybe 50 is normal. No, what about it? What is the doctor saying about it? Alex? So, he's not a market. Like all appendices, the market doesn't need a pupil to operate it. Not all the resources have same value, and the exchange rate changes depending on the resource you have to offer. Obtain ore. Wait. We give wood. We have nothing, but we give wood. And we want to have ore. What you vote for 1 hour? Ay. Okay, fish. We don't have fish. We don't have. Oh, but stone would be good, huh? We need a lot of stone. Okay, wait. How many? Okay, it's 400. We need 120. Okay. Yeah. So we need to get more wood. So we call her also wood gatherer, and then we collect now first wood. So I think I understood now some stuff. I go back to doctor in 4 days, but I don't think it should be anything serious. And again, you never know. Just annoying. Yeah, it's so long. I would be a bit worried that, you know, why it's not returning yet completely. All good, Alex. You don't have to excuse yourself. I'm glad you found something you enjoy. And yeah, if you don't have like 2 monitors and stuff like that, then usually it's not nice to watch a stream and play something on the side. Okay, we have wood, but you need more wood. Exchange wood for ore. Okay, but we have now enough wood. I would now say we do first trading. Yeah, I think I make it like this. I think I take now this one and we make here a query. Oh, I think, see, that's a difference. So you can make with 100 wood, you can make a query here, which we can't take with us in the future. Or you can make a mobile version, which costs much more. For that you need ore, wood and wool, which you don't have. But if you build the mobile version, you can take it with you when the building is, also when you're moving on with your caravan. That's pretty cool. That playing and watching with single monitor is not it's also not fun, Alex. It's also not fun. I totally understand it. So the best thing what I ever did, I think, in my life is to get 2 monitors. At the start, it was really... I didn't really use it proper. And I didn't appreciate so much. But now, you know, if you get used to it, you don't want to miss a second monitor. It's really, really nice. But I can understand if you have only one, it's not really working out. And it's also not enjoyable. But it's good that you found something what you like so much. Hi Xashara, how are you doing? Okay guys, the jungle has been decimated. The tribe has collected all the wood from this jungle. Pupils are respectful people who only take what they need. A pupil has no sense for ownership. So little that they don't even have their own assigned beds. They do what they can to leave as a little trace of their passing as they can, and look after the lands they cross by replanting as they leave. Nature does not forgive easily and will punish a harmful tribe. As such, if pupils stay too long in one place and start to be too much of a burden, nature will push them along. Do not spend too long at each hold and don't take resources the tribe doesn't need. For climatic and mystical vagaries could strike the tribe down. Okay. Okay, so we need... What do you? Make stone now. So. And then we need to get the market. We trade. Achso, okay. Good. The trading is immediately. Great! A friendly tribe has sent you ore. Complete the hold objective by gathering all the necessary resources, then go to the eye using the map. Okay. Also wait. And you? Also. Okay, also. And it's good. So she went over to the next forest. I don't have to assign her to a different forest. It just works automatically. I think we just have now to read. We need to get 120 stone, we need more wood, and we need ore. And we will use the wood to treat. So now we're playing and watching is better with two of them. And even many other things. Yeah, I think also working is better with two monitor, because then you have like one which you can use for typing, the other one for your research or stuff like that. So, or working on one and watching on the other side, something else. So. I mean, I can understand that some people watch on the phone because of that, because they don't have two. But yeah, I don't really like to watch on a small phone or something, and then you still can't concentrate on your game. So. Yes, let's wait a bit. Ay. When we have enough stone, then we can switch that our lady here is also going for. So, we have enough stone. So now we tell our axolotl to get wood. And I think I will send her here. So we're changing now because, see, there are 33 turns we will get over flooded. So we have to be a bit careful that we do the right stuff. So. Let's wait. Yeah, no worries, Alex. I mean, when one day you will get a new PC with a new setup, and then you can make it work. Pupils are able to sense oncoming events. However, unexperienced pupils are not very good at predicting their arrival. You can only sense them one turn before they occur. Next turn, your workers will be stuck with a bad fever. Oh, unassign them from the task to give them some rest by having them move. The work may be too intense, or it is warning from the spirits. Each pupil who works in harvesting, production, or construction becomes sick. Oh. How do I unassign them? Unlock. I don't know how to undersign them. Yeah, I have no clue, guys. How can we undersign these guys? No. I have no clue. I have no idea. Because I can make here...
1 year anniversary! Thank you!
Starshara, thank you so much. Yippee! 1 year already! I can bake, my friend! Thank you so much for your long, long time support. It's really appreciated. Thank you very, very much. Okay, I still don't know what to do. Works in harvesting, production, or construction becomes sick. We just have to... Ah, okay, I think just like this. I think now I unassigned them. The work may to be intense, or it's a warning from the spirits. Each pupil who works in harvesting, production, or construction becomes sick. Okay, so we did everything all right. They're not sick. Good, good. So we need more wood. Okay, now they're going back to be pandas. They collect now wood. Yeah, we have really not much time left. Was? I didn't see it. Take a look at the price of PCs now. I bet I could buy a PC that is exactly twice as strong as my PC for the same money I gave when I was buying it. That could be. I mean, you know. So usually it's better if you buy a PC, if you build your PC yourself. It's usually better because... But yeah, you need some experience, of course. Want a balloon like that in ESO? That would be awesome. Yeah, maybe someday. I mean, you can just save for it. I mean, now they will release many new components. Then maybe you don't need a high-end PC. But... Yeah, maybe find something what you like. So... Market? Okay, we need one more ore. Okay, so we're done. We have 60, we have enough wood, we have enough ore, and we have enough stone. So, and we have here already downpour. The rain is here. Each turn, the rain causes a lake or a bog to flood. Plains near lakes and bogs can be flooded, and bogs near lakes can become lakes. Okay, it sounds like we should move on. So. Here we go. In as far as the IU score depends on the rescued pupils. Along with the resources and buildings you have with them. Appendices are buildings carried by Rhinophalos. They instinctively follow the caravan and accompany your tribe on every step of the journey. As they have their own Rhinophalos, they don't take up space in a stockpile. As such, each appendix build is systematically follows the tribe until the eye. Take as much as possible to the eye so the pupils have all they need. Okay, so we have now our big guy, then our market, and some food. Shoot and Hanky have arrived at the eye. You! They are impatient to share their newly gained knowledge with the other tribes. In a few blinks, the waves will have covered the entire surface of the world and all the pupils will have gathered at the eye. A new cycle comes to a close. By the fire, lost in the thought, the two pupils have already left for the next cycle. Climbing the great western cliff will only be a formality. But what will the third cycle ceremony have in store for them? Gut. So. Chapter 3. The Shapeshifters. Help Krak and Sion, two ambitious pupils, to become experts. On how to gain experience and choose bonuses in the trade wheel, and how to feed your pupils. Build, manage, improve and repair mobile buildings and discover proximity bonuses. Visit ancient remains. Krak and Sion await only you to meet their destiny. Pupils are metamorphs by nature. As long as they can remember, animal instincts have followed them in all their tasks. Like the scent of an eye, naturally dilating in the darkness, a pupil's form shifts. If its body instinctively knows the best form to take for the task at hand. Every pupil has, from the first cycle, taken on the appearance of the red panda. All tribes need to harvest resources. Quickly enough, it's a reassuring and familiar form that shapes the day-to-day routine. Some silhouettes are much less habitual and are only worn by the elder pupils or the younger prodigies. Other forms are so rare that no one can say if they really exist. The elders say that these animals evolve, that they have seen them become rarer and rarer before disappearing, just as they see the birth of new animals. Young pupils often speak by the fireside of shapes with long horns and complex as an oak in the winter. They also mention web-footed patricians able to breathe underwater. With shadow puberty, they amuse themselves by showing off the shapes that fill their dreams. Okay. Ay. So much text. Krak has always been a teller of campfire legends. At each meet, the elders see Krak dancing around them, catching every last crumb of each story. Krak wants to become an engineer. Whenever the opportunity presents itself, Krak builds and builds. The status of expert is only achievable with experience. For now, despite having built a great many structures, Krak is still only a little bird. The little bird dreams of the day when it can become a toucan. Okay. When it becomes a toucan with a majestic beak. Sion, the other pupil of Krak's circle, has some aspirations in another domain. To become an expert in fruit harvesting and learn the famous candied fruit recipe from the elders. This recipe lets the maker sublimate fruits into something much more nourishing. This is a circle filled with hope and ambition. Select the map to see their journey. Okay. Okay, so we are here. That's good. So we are here. So the tribe is here. They've already covered a lot of the distance to the eye. And in two holes, they will have arrived. The land behind them are already under waves. No. Choose the hold for the next pass to wield the cross. Good! Thank you so much for the read! How are you doing? Thank you very, very much. Bye bye, Alex! Bis bald! Schlaf schön, süße Träume! I did not know that it's a panda, Semio. Ooh, CJ, how are you? I'm doing good food, thank you so much. What did you play today? The pupils will need a raft, really? To take this path. Wood logs and sail woven out of peep wool should do the trick. The river is long, as they should also take along some pipkins to avoid starvation. Okay. The caravan is here. The tribe already has building a pasture. This building allows for shearing and stocking peep wool. This wool can be used for making hangings, warm clothes or insulate buildings. Start to complete the objective by assigning Sion to pepkin harvesting. Explore the hold with Krak to try and find some wool. Okay. Sion? Pepkin harvesting. So, and you? Krak should explore. Okay. Even so, Sion is harvesting pepkins, the tribe's stock is running out. Pupils consume food each turn. When there's nothing left to eat, they fall ill and lose health. Oh. When they no longer have any health points, they are called back to the Sai. You must therefore keep an eye on them and feed them. Ooh. There's Fallout New Vegas and I'm lost again. Oh no! Lost again? But I hope you still enjoy it, Fruit. Yeah, they're whispering all the time. We're still in the tutorial. It's like a third part of the tutorial, so we're still learning the game. Yeah. It's like a building management game. Something like that. Okay. Pepkins are very resilient fruits that can be found in every region. They are the basis of good diet, and pupils eat 6 pepkins per day. Raw pepkins are juicy but not very nourishing. Just as Krak dreams of construction, Sion wishes to make sure everyone in the trap has enough to eat. This is Sion's trade reel. Click on it to see Sion's talents. Oha! Oha! Okay. This is pupil's trade reel. It represents all the forms a pupil can take. Every harvest cycle, build or production that a pupil performs will bring them experience points in the trades they practice. After gaining a certain amount of experience, they gain bonuses or talents that will make them better at the trade. These bonuses only apply while the pupil is working in its specific trade. The central wheel represents the base trades which later specialize into expert trades. Sion already has a lot of experience as a gatherer. And already benefits from a few bonuses. Sion requires less food than Krak, for instance. Soon Sion will be able to specialize as a fruit gatherer and take on a new appearance. Oh, ah so, come on. See here, you get a piggy and the rabbit. Ah, okay. The rabbit is a baker. Ah, see? That's pretty cool. So these are the base forms, and then they can learn this stuff. And then later on, when they specialize, they get can this. Ah, yeah. Okay. But it looks really overwhelming at first glance, right? Okay, soon Sion will be able to specialize as fruit gatherer. Look at Krak's talents by clicking on their name. Also here, Krak. So here is the other guy. Can you bake a cake? Oh, I didn't bake a cake for quite a while. It could do so, yes. So Krak has gained experience as a builder. Even at the center of the eye, some of the buildings are Krak's originals. Focus as a builder is gained by constructing new buildings. A pupil with experience in a trade will be more efficient than other one with no experience, thanks to the bonuses. Okay, so he has more points when he's building. He can repair faster. And the buildings have more HP when he is building. Okay. Okay, Bovre, enjoy your snack. Okay, so what did we want to do? Ah, so this one should explore, right? Some peeps. Ah, so these are peeps. These creatures are friendly and willingly let pupils unburden them of their wool. They hate rain and generally hide during downpour. Okay, some llamas. This pasture is a mobile. This one here? That one? This pasture is a mobile building. It's far from the peeps, and harvesting the wool will take forever. Fortunately, it's a mobile building. It can be moved whenever you like with no additional cost. Click here to repack. Okay. Repack. Okay. It's Krax's job to reinstall the building. Open Krax's constructions menu. Here. Pack. Pasture. And we place it here. Okay. So now it's here. See? There are small peeps. This hold is rather peaceful. There are a lot of resources and many peeps to provide wool. Krax wants to take advantage of this calm to build a new building that will be of use later. Since the last hold, Sion has mentioned the need for this installation. Even so, Sion has been harvesting without fail since the beginning of the hold, evolution has not yet come. There's not much left to learn as gatherer, and since the last hold, Sion has learned nothing new. Despite feeling that there must be a way to improve and specialize, Sion lacks a place to truly find personal enrichment. The caravan can only let pupils gain experience in the base trade. Pupils who work from the caravan will stagnate and never evolve. To specialize, the pupil must work in a building linked to the desired trade. To specialize, Sion must work in a harvest hut rather than in the caravan. It is the only way a pupil can experience in a higher trade. Build a mobile harvest hut, Krax will be delighted to do so. Okay, so... Okay, wait. Krax. Build. Sawmill, nee. Here, harvest hut. Oh, okay. We need wood for it? Nee, mobile one. Okay. So we need wool and wood and stone. Okay. So. Let me we start with wood maybe, or? Or. Yeah. Okay. Enjoy your look, CJ. Okay. I mean, first I would not say we make something different with our gatherer, but since we need to take care that we have enough food, I don't want to remove him. How many wood did we need? I don't know. I think 50. So let me check. Krax. Okay, now we need wool. Okay. So. So we take you, Krax. And you make the wool thingy. Eh? Also, did we not build this stuff? Yeah. I don't understand. Ach so! Oh no, did I make it kaputt or what? Ach so. Oh. Ach so, okay. I removed him from building. That was my, okay. So, it was my mistake. So, because he was walking here and I thought this is already done, that we are done, but I have to put it here. And you see, we need 3 turns to complete it. And that was my mistake. So now it's completed. Now we let him gather. Cool. Yeah. But you really had that quick style? How was that? Oh, now we have the wool, you see? Okay. So, wir haben wo? So now we can make this one. I did not open here the map. Okay. So now we build a gather hut for Zion. Okay. Okay. So, and now we assign him to the hut. Zion has finally gained experience. Open a trade wheel. Okay. So this is now Zion. He now improved. And now we can decide. Gained experience is represented by a blue gauche around the next bonuses. When the gauche is filled, the pupil gains a level. Zion has gained the first level as a fruit gatherer. Choose one of the two bonuses. This choice is definitive. The bonus will only apply while Zion is in the form of a fruit gatherer. It's the first step towards expertise and the famous recipe for candied fruits. A pupil is an expert when they have maximum experience in a higher trade. They can choose one of two permanent bonuses. These bonuses are special and apply permanently, no matter the pupil's current trade. Okay. So 15 per harvest? 15, is it experience? I think that means experience, oder? Okay. I think that's experience, I just took down that. So okay. Now do you are collecting these and you are collecting wool. I don't like having the toe nails clipped, so I had to hold them still by my arms around the necks, and I had to hold the rope. Oha. It sounds like a unique experience, Quickstar and Bloomhook. Okay. Also now we have enough to eat, so we can, in theory, switch around. I don't think we get any bonuses if you switch here. Maybe make this one. Yeah. So this one has only the unique bonuses when it's like collecting food. Okay, we have enough wool. Oh no! Oh, okay, now I saw my mistake. Oh, you saw my mistake. Okay. Sorry. So what I forgot about, we are eating also. Our characters are eating. And I forgot about it. And, yeah. When we are eating, we lose the food stuff. And then they starve. So we can't remove our gatherer from gathering food. Oh, see now, they got now already our... Oh oh. Oh oh. Oh oh. I think they die now, guys. I think I messed up. Oh no, I think I messed up and they die. Oh, I think I just got it in time. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. Oh. I totally forgot that they have to eat. But I think now we can go. We have our wood, we have wool, and we have something to eat. So I think we can just go further. Huh? Okay, so we have to pack the buildings. Everything. Okay. Oh, let's leave. Okay. This halt is an ancient forest biome. It is probably filled with ancient historic buildings. This is the last halt before the Eye. The tribe is finally at the end of its long journey. They must cross a white raven using a zip line to reach the Eye. It's not possible for just anyone. Only an engineer can prepare a safe passage through the caravan. It's time for Krak's skills to shine, to become an engineer before the waters reach the tribe. Okay, so we need one engineer, 200 wood, 10 ore, and wool. Uh-huh. Fulfill the objective and get everyone safely to the Eye before the waters come. Choose well where to place the caravan and deploy your mobile buildings to collect wool and feed your tribe with pepkins. If you construct buildings on an adjacent hexes, they will gain a proximity bonus. The yield will be increased. This bonus is represented by stakes or flags around the building. Okay. Okay, wait. Maybe so. Here, here's ore. It's not difficult. Let's see. Okay, maybe here. Here? I don't know. So I just decided now we go here, so. Okay, where are my friends? What? Sion died from hunger? They died from hunger while they were inside because I was moving around. Oh my god. I don't have pupils. Krak died from hunger. Sion died from hunger. How should I know that they just die from hunger? I move around. Oh my god. Oh yeah, yeah. Yeah, guys. That's how you play the game. You just let your pupils starve. Hmm. Okay. Can we restart? Achso, oh no. Oh no, I did not save. Oh nein. Nein, I didn't want to. It didn't ask me anything. Oh, nein. I did not say, hey, do you want to really do that? Okay, we have to restart on it now. No. Save. Oh, I don't even know if there's a save button, to be honest. Now, when we just talk about it. You know, here, this by the campaign. I don't know if there's any save button. Because you've continue, settings, back to the menu. So I'm not sure if there's any save here in this tutorial, to be honest. So, welcome back, Bouffré. Enjoy your meal. Okay, let's just try again. Okay. Okay. I mean, now I should probably better know what to do, right? Eieiei. Or maybe next time I take more food with us. So. No. I needed to... Okay, so here's my building. Ay, ay, ay. Ay. What a harsh tutorial here when I can kill my pupils. That would be a good idea, Hexe. They should take some lunchbox with them on the balloon, right? It's completed. Okay. You need 12 turns until you can harvest again. Did you already calculate? You just made a lesson mistake. Now we know, now we need more to eat. So, I learned something. We need more food. So what did you need for the hut? I don't remember. Oh. Mobile hat. Ah, wood now. Okay, okay. Sorry. Oh, that sounds fantastic, Bouffré. Property. Don't want to end up like folks in game. Sounds like a good idea. Okay, so now. Now you go. Yeah. So I think I got it now. So. So see you got experience. Okay, since we are now here, I think I will take more to eat. In this case, so we take more fruits. Here, give me more to eat. There we go. Okay, we have now enough wood. Wait, we take one more wood. So. And now, okay, do you take the wool? Sorry. Hi, Zed Buffer! Okay. 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 So, we have now. Everything is back. We should now be able to go away. So now we go on this one. Let's see, move. So first we take our mobile stuff with us, right? Then we take this one. So then I got something to eat for us a little bit. So then we have some wood. We have some wool. A little bit stone. So okay, now we leave. So was much quicker, huh? So. Okay, let's try again. Okay, guys. So we have now. Choose well where to place the caravan and deploy your mobile buildings to collect wool and feed your tribe. So. Okay, Hexe. Have a good night. Sleep well. Sweet dreams. We have now 83 pepkins, so I have something to eat. I see we lost you something. Okay. Okay, I think we deploy now. Should we deploy here? I go here. Or here. So, okay. So we have to remember we always take enough to eat with us. Okay. So where is my friend Krak? Friend Krak. You will. I see. He's here. Best builder. Best grower. And he's a gatherer, so he has gathered many different things, see? Can we? I see. Ah, okay. So he learns, you see, he's learning different ways what he can do. Ah, yeah, okay. Okay, okay. See? Okay. So, how is that? Packed mobile buildings here. So we have our harvest hut. Make it here. So. And you will go and gather something to eat already. You can go here. So. Because we need to eat food. So. Sion is our best gatherer. Okay, good. So we have this one now. So now we tell our gatherer gather from here, because when the gatherer is gathering from the harvest hut, it gets XP plus it's much closer to go from there. So and we tell our other friend here to go and explore here the rest of the map. Yeah, Miss Mousy Mouse woke up. These are remains from an ancient times. They are leftovers from previous cycles. Traces of the passage of an early tribe of pupils. Reclaimed by nature. Exploring remains can be dangerous or beneficial. You never know what you can find. Krak is fascinated by old buildings and wants to visit all of them. Krak is delighted at the idea of sharing the tribe's discoveries with all the others once they reach the eye. To visit remains, assign the exploring pupil with a right click and choose explore. Exploring the remains will take one turn. Okay. Explore? He's not qualified? Krak spends the day reconstructing the sawmill that had collapsed into these remains. Transforms into permanent sawmill. Oha. Oha! Okay, this was pretty cool. Good night, Logan. Sleep well. Sweet dreams. Have a good rest. So, okay. Now we have a sawmill. Assign a pupil to a sawmill and they will start harvesting wood. The sawmill is the only way to for a woodcutter to earn XP to build a build on a plane. Find and visit three remains of the ancient forest. Okay, so. So we let him explore more.
Welcome back. Your steadfast loyalty is greatly appreciated.
Aldo, hey, how you doing? Welcome back so much. Thank you so much for 13 months. How are you, Aldo? How have you been? Thank you so much for your support. Huh? Oh, we have now trade booms. Okay, wait. So the mobile buildings constructed by these people are more compact. 10 per harvest cycle for mobile buildings constructed by this pupil. Okay. What's there? Oh, here remains unknown. Explore this remains to discover something. Okay. Explore. By focusing their attention near the remains, Krak makes mental contact with a nearby entity. There's someone stuck under a fallen beam in this remains. Krak goes looking for the trapped pupil and finds them in a large room. The rescue is injured but is delighted to join the tribe. A pupil joins the tribe. They are hurt. Don't forget to heal them. A new pupil has joined your tribe. An unexpected earthquake surprised Sylph, tribe gatherer. The Regery destroyed all the buildings of the village and buried Sylph in a rubble inside the remains where they thought they were safe. Speaking of Sylph, sawmill must be somewhere in the hold, in a terrible state. Sylph dreams of becoming a woodcutter and will be very useful when it comes to building the zipline. Wow. What a nice accident. The tribe is now composed of 3 pupils. It's such there's 1 extra mouth to feed. Oh no. If Sion's harvesting is insufficient, the harvest hut can be improved to make it more efficient. The first harvest hut improved reduces the harvest cycle to 2 turns. Sion will be able to bring back food faster. This improvement costs resources, but will be permanent. Note, each building can be improved twice and gain 2 different bonuses. Okay. I've been super busy with the work and a puppy. Oh, did you post any new build pictures? No, oder? But I'm glad to hear that you're all doing fine. What the heck? How do I improve? I have no clue how we can improve stuff and how we can heal him. I also don't know. How can we heal him? I mean this one. I don't know how we can improve stuff. Or maybe it will tell us later. Yeah, we will probably have 2 less food. At least 1 pupil has nothing to do and can still move. Oh, so no, I cancel. Okay, wait. If it remains. Huh? Muffled sobbing guides Krak's footsteps into this abandoned building. So they make their way ever further and seem to get over closer. The corridors remain devoid of life. Unable to determine the source, Krak calls out, "Hallo!" The sobbing ceases instantly, and a surprised voice resonates in their mind. "Who are you? You fellows have left me here for so long. They always leave me. You're no different. You want to leave, don't you? Indeed, my voyage is not over. Stay longer, just a bit longer. All mobile buildings are damaged." Oh. Oh. And now? He's sick. What do we do against sickness? I have no idea. I have no idea. How can we heal someone? I don't know. It's a good question. And how can we upgrade? Good night, Fruit! Thank you so much! We can repack? I thought I can like right click and say here. Assign a pupil to harvest hut and they will start harvesting. The harvest hut is the only way to build. Ah, I have no clue. Okay, so but Sylvie got a level up. Send them to clinic where you had no death for 1 year. Oh, you don't want to see how often the others all died. That would be awesome, Alto. I'm sure your little puppy is already not so little anymore. So. I don't know. I mean, they said we should heal him, but I really don't know how. And we need really something to eat. So we need to upgrade the stuff, but I don't know how also. Can he upgrade it? Wait, can I maybe take him? Repair? Go to? Oh no, our people are dying. I don't know how to heal. Can you click on the symbols on the right side of the screen? Here? Yeah. Left click to focus, click to dismiss. Remains discovered. That's what we did. That's where here. Here. Already salvaged, yeah. It's our new pupil. That's the one we already looked into. Yeah, and that stuff is out. So. So, here we have our stuff. That's where we have to go. I have no clue. Also. What I'm doing when I don't have any food anymore? Oha. Can we build other buildings? Yeah, we can. I can make sawmill, quarry. I mean, I have to make a quarry anyway for the ore. Harvest that we have. And I can make a market. I don't see any help function, to be honest. Like this. Nothing to heal, alright? Yeah, I don't know. I mean, they said I should not forget to heal, but I don't know how. I really don't know. I mean, they said I should heal my guy, but I don't know how. I have really no clue how we can do that. I can repair. They also told me we should improve the building to get more food. But I don't know how. You know, I don't know what to do. What should I do? I can say where it should work. I can see his streets. And when I right click on this building, I can only say go to. And he's here. And on the building itself, we can repack. We can set which hexes. Should be trio and yo. I have no clue. And I would say we have to do it because needed for the color. Pupil's color. You can also change the color if you prefer it. Here. There you go. And it's just a different color there. And then unlock selection window is just this one. So I would say since the tutorial told us we should improve it, we have to improve it, right? But I have no clue how. I don't know. Now yeah, this one can, but he needs to earn more XP. But he said, the tutorial said, that we probably need more food. And in order to get more food, we have to upgrade the building so Cyan can collect more food. You know what I mean. So I think we have to upgrade it, but I don't know how. I have no idea. So don't know. Yeah, I know. I know. What? Why is the guy going there? Are you kidding me? Oh lol. I thought he can just move from here to there and get to the ore. Oh, did I do something wrong? Oh no, I made a quarry for stone. Oh no, that was my mistake. So what do I need for ore? Ah so! I thought... What? No, it was right. It's for ore. And here's for stone. Oder? Eh? Now I'm confused. A 10% ore per harvest cycle. What do we need then? I did not know. It's the wrong building. Ah, sure. I have no clue. Oh, we need a mine. Ah, we need a mine. Okay, wait. Okay. And then just look. Okay, I don't know. I thought I can Google, but I guess the game is too new. There's no wiki or something, so I have no clue how to, you know. I thought I can maybe find the solution, how to upgrade the building, but I don't know. Okay, now you make this one. So we have already enough, okay. Okay. So now you will go and do the who thingy. And you also no. You should do this one here. I mean, what? No. Do you have to eat? Where are you? Oh, we don't have any. Oh my god. We don't have any. Oh, yeah. Oh no, she's going here. This is mobile. Wait. We have to repack this. Yes. Where's my guy? We need. Crack. Okay, now we probably die, guys. It could be we die because they have to walk so far away. Oh no, one died, guys. Oh no! Defeat. And a poncho drifts away slowly to the floor as the pupil is dispersed by the breeze. This story is already written, and this was not their destiny. They were meant to reach the eye and the end of this cycle. Open the way. We start a chapter and save them all. The pig is the cook, I think, Blumok. I think the pig character avatar is when you're cooking, when you make your master cook. And the rabbit was a baker. Yeah. Wait, I want to check what is custom. So if you want to make a custom game, you can decide probably where you start or how it looks like. How many pupils, of how much food. Traits, there are negative and positive traits. How long the way is and the seat. Yeah. Good, guys. It's anyway midnight, so it was tough here for learning. For learning, it was tough. But what do you think, guys, so far about the game? What's your thoughts? How do you find it? Is this something you enjoy? Or maybe enjoy? Like the game a lot? You think we get it yourself? Yeah, I don't think there's any fighting, Sifi. I think that's a really peaceful journey. I mean, they are like, what I understood, there are stuff like nature disasters, stuff like that, but I think nothing else. Just have the pressure that the nature's coming and sickness and things like that, but no, not like fighting another tribe, I think. I mean, they're just even fine without fighting. As you saw, it's easy doable. I'm a profi pupil by accident killer. NP. So, working fine. If I want or not. If I want or not. I tried my best. So. Okay. Like I said, sometimes I don't like you. Another game I want to play. But I just put it on your wishlist. It helps already quite a lot, guys. If you like a game, put it on your wishlist. It can help also the developers. No point playing Amo until you find how to heal. But otherwise, yeah. I mean, I think it's good. I think the start was really good. Of course, I need to find out quite a lot. So it could have been better made when you play the tutorial, right? That they tell you that. Don't think you guess what's going on? Now, more or less is you have a tribe who has to reach the middle of the map because in a specific amount of time there's coming a huge wave which kills everyone. So, and this happens all the time again and again. And so, which means there's always a cycle where these little guys, these shapeshifters, have to reach the middle of the world on a big mountain to be safe of the big flooding. And when the flooding goes away, then they can return to their normal lives. So that's like more or less the story. Oh. And you have to make your way with your caravan there, and there are different obstacles you have to overcome to make it in the middle and rescue your guys. If you're like me, they will all just starve. So that's how it goes. Yeah. But yeah, we will see, guys. But now we go to sleep. And yeah, thank you so much for joining. I hope you enjoyed our evening with watching Ubisoft stuff, talking, and trying out a new game. Thank you so much, everyone, for being here. That's really, really appreciated. So, good night, Zed Buffer. Sleep well, sweet dreams. Good night, Cherisil. Good night, Garrett. Quickstar, sweet dreams to you also. CP and Tommy, have a good night. Toxic, sleep well and sweet dreams. But nothing for you to play. Okay, fair enough. Good night, Samuel. Good night, Logan. Good night, Hexe. Bloomhawk, sweet dreams to you. Ella Blues, have a good night. Xashara, sweet dreams. Killy, have a good night. TomTom, sleep well. Nico, also good night. Curse, have a good night. Faiso, sweet dreams. Good night, Crazy. Good night, Old Mama Dragon. Good night, Fuzzy Louie. Good night, Bufre. Sleep well, my friends. Have a good night. We visit now Inai. So let's go to her, to him, sorry, and say hello. And say hello for our community. Good night, Narosa. For now, good night, my friends. Sleep well. Sweet dreams. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Tschüss.